This tutorial will guide you through using the Design Manager Pro Groups feature. Groups are used to further organize items within each location. For example, when using item groups, you can have an accent chair in the guest bedroom location, where the accent chair can become the item group name. You can then create new items that can all be added in connection with that group. Each of the items below the group can become the major pieces of the accent chair, such as a style or frame, fabric, or pillows. Then each of those items can have components as well. For example, a pillow can then have a fabric, trim, and stuffing, all as components of the pillow item. Each of the items can be connected to the main group for the accent chair. When a proposal or invoice is generated and project specifications include a group name, you will notice that the proposals and invoices will now list the items by location, then by group. A group total will also appear. To get started using groups, you must first turn on item groups in your Company Information Advanced setting. To do so, go to File, Company Information and Settings, click on the Advanced button, and go to the General tab. Then select the Item Groups option. Click OK and OK again to save your change. When you go to Project Specifications, you will now notice a Group Name column on your item grid. A new field for group name will also appear on your item window. Here you can type in a group name to use. Using our example, the group name will be Accent Chair. Once you have entered a group name, it will become available for selection from the search for all items created for that project. Generate your items and join them to their main groups. In our example, we will edit current items and add them to two separate groups so that we can demonstrate how the group will separate the items that are in different groups but have the same location on our documents. We will use the group for the accent chair and add another for a sofa. Each group will have a few items underneath them. Once you have finished entering your items or editing items to include your group name, you can create a new proposal for these items. If there's only one group needed for your proposal, you can use the Tag button to have the system auto-tag all of the items within that group. You can also tag the items by selecting the location. Otherwise, tag all items necessary for your proposal manually. Once you have tagged the items needed, select OK to create a preview of your proposal. You will notice the location list first, and then the groups appear with the items within each group. You will also see the proposal shows a total for each of the groups. After previewing the document, select the X to close out and accept or reject the proposal. This concludes our tutorial on using item groups. To review more tutorials and knowledge base articles, please visit our Help Center at designmanager.com.